Everyone, in the previous video we have discussed some concept of strings, that is about the concatenation concept. In this video we are discussing the next concept, that is transpose, which is an extension of the concatenation concept, also prefix and suffix, and also terminal and non-terminal symbol. So we can move to that. That is, here is the transpose operation. So what is a transpose operation? For transpose operation, that is, for example, if I am having x is equal to 0 1, then its transpose, that is x transpose, is equal to write it from the backward, that is 1 0 will be the what x transpose. So for transpose, just reverse the string. Next, it is an identity, that is x is in sigma star, that is x can contain epsilon, but next string must not contain epsilon. Why it is? If both strings are epsilon, then epsilon is equal to epsilon, then there is no need for this identity. So you can have at least one string as epsilon, you cannot have both the string epsilon. One string must be having element. Okay, so that is an extension principle of concatenation. Here concatenation plus transpose it is coming. So once again I will say, before going into the identity, transpose means just reverse the string. So x equal to 0 1 means we are using alphabet set what 0 comma 1. So x is, I am writing as it is, and a is equal to, I am writing 1 1, I am writing, then a into x transpose, xa will become xa is equal to 0 1 1 1, it will become, and next one xa transpose, it will become right from the here, so it will become what 1 1 1 0. So this is xa transpose. Now we can write what a into x transpose. A means here, x transpose means this. So a into x transpose, that is equal to what 1 1 1 0. So these both are same, that is, if a x can contain null, a must not contain null, then we can have the identity xa transpose is equal to a into x transpose. This is a particular identity because it will not work for all strings, it will work for only some strings, that is palindrome like strings. Not all palindrome also, it is not palindrome as it, palindrome like strings. For example, now look at this. This is a special string 1 0. If it is reversed, it will become 0 1. It will reverse, it become what 1 0. So here I am taking a as 1 1. So in some way these two, in both these two, the strings must be repeated. Either x must contain 1 1, or y must, a must contain what 1 1 or 1 1 or 0 0, like that repeated string it must contain, then will it only work. That is special string. You must look strings like that, such that xa transpose is equal to a into x transpose. It will not work for all strings. That is a very basic thing. I am string, it will not work for all strings like that. It will work for special strings only, but it is an identity, it works for 50% string. Next 50% string it will not be worked. So for up to efficiency 50%, so it is proved as a theorem in the theory of computation, because this thing is very important when you move to design the machine. That is why I am saying, but I will again say, this is not work for all strings. palindrome like string, not palindrome, it will be working. What do you mean by palindrome? Palindrome means, for example, Amma is a palindrome. It is an even length palindrome. What do you mean by even length? We can split into two parts, that is called what? Even length palindrome. Malayalam is an odd length palindrome, because when you split into two parts, in the middle where we get Y will be get a, that is called what? Odd length palindromes. So Amma is an even length palindrome, such that here when we take a string X and X transpose is called what? Palindrome. That is a very important identity when you are saying about palindrome. That is X and X transpose A string and its transpose is called what? Palindrome. So it is an extra palindrome is an extension principle of what? Transpose. So that is about transpose operation. Transpose operation, we have discussed an identity which work for some strings only, all strings cannot be worked. It will work for the strings like that. In one strings the alphabets must be same, that is what alphabet we are taking, that must be same, and that type strings will only work for this. And next one is palindrome. Palindrome, we have odd length and even length palindrome. Okay, next is terminal and non-terminal symbol. For example, I will say an example from C language. That is, if is a terminal symbol, if A greater than B as a non-terminal symbol, or very simple operation, that is A is equal to B into C. B into C. This B is a terminal and C is a terminal, but this expression is a non-terminal, and when we assign it to a symbol, it is also a non-terminal. Once again I will say, if I having set, my alphabet set is containing B comma C, so I can make only strings with the help of what? B comma C. So this B and C are what? Terminals. What is your alphabet set? From that alphabet set we are making what? Strings. So the strings we are making is called what? Non-terminals. And from that non-terminals you can again make strings, that is from strings you can again make strings. For example, is a string, NT is also a string, so we are again making a string what? Is indeed. That is the concept here. We have two non-terminals, we can again make what? Again we can make non-terminal. So once again I will say, terminal symbol is the symbols of your basic alphabet set from which you can build strings, that is indivisible. We cannot divide, we cannot substitute B as any another value, because B is the basic alphabet set. Oh, they are called what? Terminal symbol. From the terminal symbol you make any sentences or any strings, that is called what? Non-terminal. We can subdivide it, because here A can be substituted with the value what? B into C. So that is called what? Non-terminal symbol. Okay, so next is, we are discussing about the prefix and suffix of the string. Prefix means a substring, that is leading symbols of that string. For example, if you are taking 101, leading symbol means left hand side. So epsilon is the prefix of every string, because epsilon into X is equal to what? X itself. So leading symbol what will? Epsilon we can take. Next what? 1 we can take. Next leading symbol, leading symbol means friend symbols, 10 we can take. And next is a very important concept in theory of computation, 101 is the prefix of itself. Okay, next one is the suffix. Suffix means we are taking string as a whole, then trailing symbol. Trailing symbol means what? Back end symbol. So this is the suffix of itself. Next, we are taking from the back, move towards here, that is 0, 1 we are taking. And next one, move towards here, it 1, that epsilon is the trailing symbol of everyone because x epsilon is equal to what x itself. So in prefix, we are taking one by one from the left side. So in the suffix, we are taking one by one and move towards what right side we are moving. So in the right hand, symbols are taken, that is here, then what epsilon we are taking. I think you have got a clear idea about this string. I have made two videos of strings, that is part 1 and part 2. In part 1, we have discussed about the concatenation. In the part 2, we have discussed about the transpose, and in that palindrome, prefix, suffix and non-terminal symbol. It is a very important concept as coming into the theory of computation, because from this we build the language of the machine. So if you do not understand this concept of string, you cannot build or you cannot draw the machines diagrammatically. So please watch it with very patience and understand concept one by one. Okay, if you have any doubt, we can discuss in our live classes. Thank you all.